Hello children, today we are going to revise the lesson light. Children, first thing I told you about the light, what light is a kind of energy. Okay, light is a form of energy. Second, I told you it moves in a straight line. What do we call that? That light travels in a straight line. This phenomena is called rectilinear propagation of light. Propagation of light. Okay. Because of this rectilinear propagation, shadows are formed. Because it is moving in a straight line, any object come in between, it forms shadow. So shadows are formed. As a result, shadows are formed as a result of rectilinear propagation of light. Okay, children. Now, what is reflection? Next is reflection. Bouncing back of light is called reflection. Okay, there are two types of reflecting surfaces. Regular surface and irregular. Regular surfaces, they form regular, like reflection. The image formed by these regular surfaces is like we can see the object is parallel. A regular surface reflects a parallel beam of light incident upon it only in one direction. And a rough surface reflects a parallel beam of light incident upon it in all direction. So in this we get the diffuse reflection, or we cannot see the object, image of the object, but in this we can see. The example is plane mirror. The image formed by a plane mirror, example of regular surface is plane mirror. The image formed by a plane mirror, okay, because we can see the image formed by plane mirror because it is a regular surface. Okay, and there are two types of images, children. I told you two types: real and virtual. Real image we can get on screen. We can obtain it on screen. And other is virtual image, we cannot obtain this on screen. Okay, we cannot obtain this virtual image on screen. Real image is always inverted, upside down, inverted. And this image is always erect. This forms behind the mirror and this front of the mirror. And we can catch it on screen. This is inverted, this is erect. Okay, now the characteristics of image formed by plane mirror. What are the characteristics of the image formed by plane mirror? First, it is upright and virtual. Upright, virtual. Second, it forms at the same distance. It forms at same distance, like the object is placed 5 meters away from the mirror. We can find the images 5 meters back of the mirror, like the distance between object and image is 10 meters. Third, same size. And fourth is lateral inversion. It shows lateral inversion. I told you what is lateral inversion. Our object's left is image's right. Our left hand, it seems the right hand of the image. So that is called lateral inversion. Okay. So these are the characteristics of the image formed by plane mirror. Now next thing, we are coming to the spherical mirrors. Spherical mirrors, two type. Spherical mirrors. two types. Concave, first we will discuss concave mirror. Concave mirror, you know, the mirror, the inner surface is reflecting surface and outer one is polished. What kind of images are formed in this? We are going to discuss again here. Like first I am going to tell you when the object is at infinity. Infinity means sun very far away. So from infinity the parallel rays are coming. This is curved surface. That is why you know the rays, they bent. The rays which light rays which are coming because of this this curved surface, these rays they bent at certain angle. And they are going inside, so we are going to call it converging mirror. This mirror is also called converging mirror because rays are converging. Okay, and they meet at this point. This is what focus. So, what kind of image is formed when the object is at infinity? When object is at infinity, what kind of image would be formed? Children, the image is formed, position is focus. At focus, it would be formed. And you are seeing sun is so big and here we can see the dot. So, we can see what is the nature of the image. Nature, real. Real means we can, it is forming just this side of the mirror. So, this is real. Agar back mein hota, then it is virtual. So if we are getting it in front of mirror, we can catch it on screen. So this is real. Real image is always inverted. And the size is diminished. Diminished means very small. Okay. Now opposite of this. Now object is at focus. Object is at focus. Object is at focus. What happened? Image would be formed like the first ray will come here. Okay. And then reflect. After striking the mirror, it will reflect from focus. Okay. And the second ray come to the pole. And reflect. And children, we are seeing that these two rays, they go very far away and then they will meet. So what kind of image? Opposite of this. Here, when the object is at infinity, we are getting a position of the object is focus, but here the position of the image would be infinity. Opposite of this. Okay, we don't know where it is going to form. Nature of the image, because it is going very far away, we don't know where it is going to meet. I'm just shifting this. Okay, where it is going to meet, we do not know. So we are saying the position is infinity. What is nature? Because this is forming this side of the mirror. Front of the mirror, so it is real and inverted. Now, what is the size? What is the size? When we see, it is very big, very enlarged. So, what we are going to say? Highly enlarged. So children, just opposite, these two are opposite, infinity, then make images on focus. When object is at focus, image is at infinity. So this way you can study. Now we are coming to the second one, second position. Second position, now we are shifting this. From infinity, we are coming to beyond C. Beyond C, first ray. Second, this will pass from this. Okay. Second ray will come pass from this center. Okay. This is focus. And children, you don't forget to make these arrows to show the way. Now it is passing. Okay. This is C. Second ray is passing from the focus, and after striking this, it is going like this. Now where these two rays are meeting, there we are going to make the object. Oh, sorry, image. Okay. Here we are seeing, children, I am going to erase little this thing. Okay. Now, if we see, we are shifting this side, and we are seeing the image. First it was on focus, now it is moving away from the focus. As we are shifting the object this side, image is shifting that side. What kind of image is formed? Because we can catch it on a screen. Real, inverted. And when we measure the size, this is small, smaller than the object, smaller than the object. Okay. And it is formed between F and C. Position is between F and C. When the object is placed beyond C, we are getting it. Okay. Now, come to the next. इसका opposite करते हैं. कहाँ पे हमारा between F and C बन रहा है? Now we are going to place the object between F and C. जहाँ image बन रही है, वहाँ हमने object place कर दिया. Okay? First ray will pass from the focus. Second ray. Okay, then thoda sa rays, I am going to draw it again. This is F, this is C, object. Okay. Now, just you see, just this is P. You are seeing this is image. A, B is object. A dash, this is B dash, A dash. You are seeing what kind of image forming this side, then real, inverted. Up, just you compare the size, which one is bigger? This is bigger. So it's bigger than the object. Bigger than the object. And what is the position? Just opposite of this. Position is beyond C. Beyond C. So children, this way we can do the practice by putting in opposite way. Up next is our... When the object is placed at C. Object is placed at C. First ray. Children, just you see here it is meeting where the object is there. Okay. So you are seeing... Where, what is the nature of the image? This is object AB, and A dash B dash is image. You are seeing image is what? Real, inverted, and same size, okay, and where? At C. Where it is forming? At C. And next is, last is, when the object is between F and P. This is F, this is P, okay. First ray will pass and second ray, children, and you will find that it seems it is coming from the back. These two rays, when we meet them, it forms like this, okay. So this image is, because it is formed behind the mirrors, so it is what? Virtual erect position and enlarged. Badi ban rahi hai. Enlarged and behind the mirror. Where it is formed? Behind the mirror. So these are the ray diagrams, children. They will come in the test. Now of convex mirror, we are going to discuss of convex mirror. In any, here reflecting surface is bulging side, this is mirror. Anywhere we are going to keep the object, we always get, this is a diverging lens. It reflects like this, okay. It seems this ray is coming from F here. Second will go there and then return from the same side. When we increase this ray, it seems it is coming from here. See, where these two rays are cutting each other, the image would be formed. Just you see the nature of the image. It is virtual, erect, behind the mirror and diminished. Bahut choti banegi. Diminished. Okay, children? So we have done with the spherical mirrors. Now we are coming to the spherical lenses. Lenses, two types. As I told you, convex lens and concave lens. This is converging lens and this is diverging lens. How I am going to tell you? Okay, thin from the edges and thick in the middle, thick in, at the edges and thin in the middle. This is, we are going to place the, like from sun the rays are coming, will go straight, and after passing, because it is transparent, it allows the light to pass. When it is, these sun rays are coming, it converge at focus. This is its focus, okay. So this is called converging lens. And this, children, if now the rays are coming and we see that after passing through this, it is what? Diverging. Okay, this is diverging lens. And when we see that from where the rays are coming, we see they are coming at this point, this is focus. Okay, this is converging lens, this is diverging lens. This is also called magnifying glass, and we use it enlarge the object when we place any object at F, okay, or very close to this, we can see the enlarged image, or it behaves like concave mirror, convex mirror. It behaves like concave mirror and it behaves like convex mirror. Wherever we are going to put the thing, we always find that diminished virtual image. And here we can get real and virtual both kind of images. Virtual when the object is placed very close. Like we use this lens like magnifying glass, we use it in telescope, microscope, etc. Now children, we are coming to the colors and uses of this. I told you like we use in magnifying glass and all. So we want to see the enlarged image of any object, so we use this convex lens. Okay, and spectacles we use convex as well as concave. For the person who is not able to see the close object, there in its spectacle, in the that person's spectacle, we use convex. And generally children, they have the problem of short-sightedness. They see the object very close and if the distant object they are not able to see. So in their specs, we use what? Concave lens. Okay. Now come to the colors, seven colors. The splitting of white light into seven color is called dispersion. Okay. Into seven colors is called dispersion. And we get this light on a screen. These seven color which we get on a screen, WebGeor. This is the sequence. This is called spectrum, visible spectrum. Okay. And frequency of violet is highest and frequency of red is lowest. That is why we get violet here and red there. Okay. And children, Isaac Newton has brought this in our notice that white light is composed of seven color. And splitting of white light is called dispersion of light. Okay. Now I am going to tell you about the Newton disc. What is Newton disc? Newton disc Newton has made. He divided equally these, divided in equally seven parts. Okay. And painted with WebGeor. And then he has rotated it very fast. And these colors, they were not visible when he rotated it very fast. We can also make and see. So it appears white. So this tells us that white light is constitute seven colors. Okay. And why we are not able to see? There is a phenomena called persistence of vision. Because of this phenomena, we cannot able to separate these color when it is rotating very fast. When it is slow, we can separate. Why? I am going to tell you. Because on our retina, image of any object remains there for 1/16 of seconds. Okay, it stays there. Lekin any image come before this, then our eyes or our nerves, optical nerves, cannot make it out. So same thing happens when we rotate it very fast. Violet color has come, our optical nerves, they identify this color, then what happened? Indigo comes, blue comes, green. So because it is rotating very fast, so our optical nerves cannot identify that and it appears white. Children, you must have seen in Science City in Lucknow the same persistence of vision, the example. That in one disc they have made the cage. Okay. Cage. One side cage and the back side of this they have made what? Bird. Okay. When they rotate, when you rotate this very fast, what happened? Like in your eyes, the image of this come and this image is still there. Then what comes? The image of bird. So what we see, that bird is in the cage. Okay. So this is just because of persistence of vision. In our retina, image stays for 1/16 seconds, and we can detect only if any other image will come before that, then we are not able to do so. So that's all, children.